Hello, friends, and welcome back to r/ProRevenge. We begin our video with a story of petty revenge on a lazy boss. But before we begin, don't forget to subscribe to our channel if you're new here and turn on notifications so you don't miss a new video every single day. Here we go. Terrible boss. Just a quick excerpt about my boss. He's extremely lazy and won't do anything himself. He won't get his own drink, his own food, he won't pick up a piece of paper that's next to him, and instead will ask for someone to hand it to him even if he's in range, etc. He'll have someone else come in and type his own emails for him at his desk because he won't do it himself. This guy's a grown man, 33 years old. He'll dictate everything you write, and if he doesn't like what you type, even though it's verbatim, he'll yell and scream at you. I took the day off work yesterday just to have a chance to play catch-up with several tasks that needed to be done. I came into work today and was there for 2 hours doing my job when one of the managers that works there comes up to me and tells me that I'm being suspended for a week. This manager has no direct power over me. He only acquiesces to what he's told. My boss, the one who apparently I pissed off for not coming into work, had the audacity to send this humble guy to suspend me instead of doing it to my face. I asked a new coworker before I left any particular reason I was being suspended. She told me that she sent out a mass email that listed all the recipients as 2 instead of blind CC. Apparently, this was a big F-up, and he yelled at her for hours yesterday. So her mistake is my fault. As if I was there, I would have somehow prevented it. I signed the form that the manager presented to me, acknowledging that my boss is too chicken crap to do it in person. Keep in mind, my boss is a lazy F. I walked to my desk and hid some relevant but not important files on my network that he won't be able to find unless he looks for it himself. Knowing that he's lazy, he won't be able to find those files until I return sometime next week. As further insult, it's a whole week for me to job hunt. I think that as soon as I find another job, I'll scale things to proper revenge just so this a-hole gets what he deserves. There's not a question in my mind, this man is the son of a millionaire. Any of his problems, he just throws money at it till it goes away. I've had 4 friends quit this job with me because of this poor excuse for a human. And our second story. Karen chews us out over a milkshake. I get her fired. So I used to work at this restaurant in the downtown city. Terrible job experience, but it was a job. One day, we get slammed. Usually it's because of a game night, since this burger place is right behind a baseball field, but this day was different. First of all, I was already pissed. Coworker who thought he was the manager showed up an hour late, so I had to open the entire front of the restaurant alone with 30 minutes because people were already waiting in the parking lot. Coworker shows up, I don't say a word to him. Oh well, move on with the day. Day goes on and I come in for my shift. Soccer teams come over after a tournament. I'm talking about 100 players with a line out the door. On shifts like this, some of the kitchen staff had to drop everything and help the other front-of-house employees, including myself, deliver orders because we're taking orders, cleaning tables, putting orders together, delivering them, serving drinks. I did this when I was 18, and making milkshakes. Customers were great. All of the players that came in were so nice and we had no issues. No impatience, no complaints, nothing. Just a nice day. They tipped us nicely as well, so we really appreciated that. I should probably mention at this point that we take DoorDash orders, which is where Karen comes in. For those of you who don't know, DoorDashers are people who are paid by a customer to go get food from a restaurant and bring it to them. We get in our usual rush, and me and 3 other coworkers are obviously multitasking and rushing to keep everyone happy. DoorDash tablet goes off, I confirm it, and start prepping the order. Mind you, this included a milkshake. I'm not going to go ahead and make the milkshake because God only knows when this woman's going to show up. Rest of the order's ready to go, and she shows up while we're helping other customers. Let me tell you about this woman. By definition, a Karen. She had the typical Karen cut with the eyes of a freaking White Walker. I'm talking bright blue eyes, obviously fake because they were Twitter logo blue and almost solid, that peer into your soul in a split second. I swear I saw the gates of hell in her eyes. So I'm just going to call her Karen. She starts getting impatient and asks me how much longer it'll be. I apologize and tell her it won't be much longer, and I go to start the milkshake. She starts flipping out at my coworkers, and as I'm passing her to get the rest of the DoorDash order, she starts laying it on me. screaming at me because I didn't have the milkshake ready and that I was costing her tips. The woman was wearing Lululemon yoga pants and had expensive colored contacts in. She'd be fine without $3. Sort of manager comes out to talk to her. Let's call him C. C comes out and explains the situation. She doesn't accept what he's saying and starts screaming in front of 200 people about how she won't get tips and how hard is it to make one milkshake. Karen gives us the typical, "I want to speak to your manager," and the manager just so happens to be C. He tells her he's the manager, he asks her to leave, and she continues her rant, calling C a coward about 5 or 6 times. Karen finally leaves. I'm fuming about this lunatic coming in and making everyone uncomfortable, so I do a little digging. Turns out, if you go onto the tablet, you can find the previous DoorDashers who come into the restaurant to get orders. I remember the name of the customer who ordered, so I go on the tablet to find the DoorDasher's name. I find her name and cell phone number on the order history and information. I get in contact with the DoorDash company and explain the harassment we endured from Karen and give them her name and contact number, saying she was from Redacted City. They tell me they'll look into it. They contacted me later and informed me that it was taken care of and we never saw her again, as she regularly took orders from us. We all went on our merry way and occasionally called each other cowards as our own little inside joke. And our last story. GM fired because of wronged employee. This story took place around 10 years ago. Some of the details are a bit fuzzy, but I do remember many of the events and people involved. The players: GM, the general manager; KM, the kitchen manager; KH, kind host; C, my cousin; PO, police officer. Background: I was born with a condition called congenital nystagmus. To put it simply, my eyes rapidly move, preventing me from seeing things clearly. Basically, without my glasses, I'm legally blind. This is important for the story. Getting and renewing my driver's license is a major pain in the butt, involving multiple trips to the eye doctor and DMV just for a restricted license. I'd been working at this restaurant for about 2.5 years at this point. It was a nightmare of a Friday night, and I was more than ready to go home. The new schedule had been posted that night, so I took a picture of the new and old schedule. You see, many employees had been written up or fired lately for coming to work late or not showing up. Their schedules were being changed without them knowing. I was covering my butt in the event this happened to me. I say my see you tomorrows and head home. I come in the next day for my lunch shift. I think I was supposed to be there around 12 or 12:30. I go to clock in and the computer's saying that I'm late and I need a manager override. I head to the office to get a manager. Me: hey, general manager's name, can you swipe me in? The computer's saying that I'm late. GM: probably because you are. Me: no, I'm supposed to be here at this time. I step out of the office to look at the schedule. In bright red ink, I see that my schedule had been changed. I take out my phone and look at the pictures I took before. Crap, I know what's about to go down. We proceed to argue, which gets the kitchen manager's attention. It had turned into a full-on screaming match. She comes to the office to sort this mess out. KM: what's going on here? I proceed to tell her what was going on. KM: not again. Remember, this had been going on for weeks now. I show her my proof and she sides with me. We go to clock me in. The GM is not having this and follows. GM: my name? I'm still writing you up. I lose my crap and curse her out on the floor. GM: don't bother clocking in. You're fired. Get out of my restaurant. If you set foot on the property, the police will be called and you'll be trespassed. This happened next to the bar. Many of the regulars and co-workers witnessed this go down. I continue my tirade and march out of the restaurant. Karma's a bee. My glasses fall off my face and I step on them. Kind host saw this and asked if I had my backups with me. Nope, I do not. She helps me to my car and I call my cousin to bring my backups from my apartment. Until then, I had to wait for my cousin to get there with my glasses. KH informs management of what's going on. That bee of a GM calls the police. I knew many of the local officers as they were regulars there. They arrive and I wave to them from the hood of my car. After a few minutes, they come over to me with GM and KH in tow. PO: hey, my name, we have to ask you to leave or we're going to trespass you. I explain my situation and show them my license. Well, KH backs up my account of the events. I can't drive without my glasses. Yes, my vision is that bad. PO agrees that I shouldn't be on the road and should stay until my cousin arrives. GM is not happy and marches back inside. The officer sticks around until my cousin arrives. I inform him of what happened, and in the restaurant he goes. P.O. has to go get him as he's cursing the GM out. I thank the officer for his kindness after they return, and I'm on my way. The revenge. A week later, I'm working at the location a couple miles up the road. The area director and district manager come in and see me. The three of us had become friendly over the years. They were wondering what I was doing at that location, so I tell them what went down. I'm now the eighth person to give them this story. They tell me they'll look into it. I get an evil idea. Me. Hey, if you're going to look into that, I got some more information you should know. The GM had a habit of coming in, doing lineup, shift meeting, give someone her card, and leaving not to return till the end of her shift. They thank me for the information and leave. About a month later, I'm having a party, mostly coworkers that were off, with more coming later. At some point in the night, everyone's phones start going off. The GM had been fired, and all of her victims could have their jobs back if they wanted. Most of us had moved on at that point. I tell those in attendance what I did. High fives all around. Moral of the story, don't F over your employees. They know the secrets of the business. Afterward. A few years later, there was a class action suit against the restaurant. I was not a part of it. I'd long moved on. Hey guys, thank you all for watching the video. I'll see you in the next one.